the high demands of our customers from Westphalia in the window profile machine building industry or in the woodworking machinery industry actually inspired us to start with PC-based control in 1986, so 38 years ago. And still, this is one of the cornerstones of our company, technology-wise. Johannes, where are we with PC-based control today?
You said that 38 years ago, 1986, we started PC-based control. That means since 38 years, we are counting on IT technology, and we're counting on Moore's Law.
That's true.
Declared by Gordon Moore in 1965 that the amount of transistors on a chip will double each 1 or 2 years.
Yeah.
And this law still applies.
Yeah, brilliant guy.
Of course, brilliant guy. But that also means that the IT technology, especially if you look at all the processors in the world, which are the most performant computational devices, which mankind created, kind of, they are growing fast, really fast, yeah, faster than the automation industry. And we think, why should we not use this IT technology? Because it's so performant, it's the most performant technology on the earth, and use it for machines, because machines should benefit from that.
Yeah.
And this is what PC-based control is a little bit about. So we are using this IT technology, are integrating it into our automation system, especially if you look at our PCs. Yeah. We are normal CPUs, which everybody knows, for example, from Intel or AMD up inside. And this is exactly, this PC is a really good example how we contribute from that, because how we benefit from that, because here is an Intel Atom CPU with its latest generation, Alcat Lake. And we simply replace the old generation Apollo Lake. Strange names, but
yeah, true.
But we use the new CPU from Intel, put them in the same form factor for the same price for our customers, and we have 50% more performance. So we still benefit from the IT technology, and we will do this for a long, long time.
Yeah, this applies for all form factors. So
exactly.
We have it for the Intel Core i processors and for the Intel Scalable processors, where we show on this exhibition the latest, greatest CPU generations. But we are also combining our standard IT processors always with standard tools, which are well known for everybody who's programming, for example, right?
That's true. So not only on the hardware, but also on the software, and on the software tools, we're of course counting on the big IT innovations in the world.
Yep.
Because everybody knows we are a Windows company. So we are using Windows and it's an operating system, because there's a lot of functionalities already built into it. We should use them for the machine. And for example, our automation software Trinket runs usually, or the engineering is done in Visual Studio. So a universal programming platform everybody knows from the IT world, every student knows when he comes from the university, and we are using that since a long, long time. So this complete IT-OT integration, we do it since 1986, and we really benefit from it.
Yeah, and it's for customers, it's very good because they can use tools which they already know, or which they already know from some other parts of the industry, from education. One very popular software topic has always been Linux. Heiko and Daniel just introduced Twinket for Linux. Can you maybe put a little bit of light around that? What's behind this? Why are we going with this step?
Yeah, Beckhoff is known to be a Windows company, and we are still a Windows company, but now we are introducing an additional operating system, Linux, which has some benefits, and it's also just an addition, because some customer demand Linux. It also fits perfectly into our philosophy, open automation control, because Linux is an open operating system with a lot of openness and functionalities which can be built in. So it really fits in our philosophy. And furthermore, it also comes with new technologies, for example, the container technology, where you can install different or multiple containers with, for example, multiple Trinket runtimes on one PC, which you can use for controlling multiple machine segments in multiple runtimes. This is a new technology which is coming with Linux, and we want to do that for our customers and bring that to our customers, because it's also requested.
Yeah, and one thing which is also very important, I think, to Heiko and Daniel, is the fact that, so the form factor of the IPCs, that's always staying the same with us, yeah? And you get new processors every now and then, but with Twinket, it's actually the same thing. So it's the same software, the same interface, the same look and feel, independent from the operating system. And one very popular Twinket function at the moment is around machine learning. So we just introduced Twinket, or we introduced Twinket Chat last year, and the machine learning creator These are two software functionalities which are very popular at the moment, and we are using machine learning in different areas of the machine. We are using it in the engineering, but we are also using it to make decisions while we are running in full real time. Why are we doing this? What is the motivation behind that?
Yeah, even though machine learning, of course, and artificial intelligence is a buzzword, but it's a buzzword for a reason, in my opinion, because it can be used in a lot of applications in a lot of different ways. It's very universal. For example, you can use machine learning and neural networks for the not really replacement, but for conducting and computing concrete algorithms.
Yep.
So therefore, since a couple of years, we have the machine learning real-time inference as a product where you can compute neural network in the Trinket real-time, so in the machine real-time, in the machine runtime. And we are also benefiting from it in our own product. So for example, we both are from the Explanar team, are really happy about machine learning because in the Explanar, we are calculating a lot of neural networks to calculate concrete algorithms, for example, for the position control. Yeah. And I think every machine could use that. And so this is one thing. And of course, the other really big thing which occurred in the last year is the use of ChatGPT or large language models or generative AI. And this will be a complete new field for automation because generative AI is, or large language models are, general human speech interface, a language interface. So you can use it in the engineering for programming, configurating stuff, or creating HMI sites, which we also show with Trinket Chat. And you can also use it in the runtime because the machine user, he can simply talk to the machine, he can just write with his normal language because the large language model will understand that. And then it's just a communicator between the human and the machine. So there will be a lot of applications in the future, and of course we are trying everything out what is possible with large language models.
I'm pretty sure Westphalian window profile processing machines will have some interesting stories to tell at the end of the day. But I think it's a very important topic for our customers to see and to get the feeling that whenever there is a new technology, because it's very much in our name as a company, new automation technology, then you can find it in the Beckhoff portfolio and we can enable PLC programmers to utilize these technologies.
Exactly, and that is also our philosophy in development. So we're looking around in the world and what are there as great technologies? Is there a new way of calculating things? Is there a new processor? Yep. What does the world give to us? Can we use it for automation?
Okay, this was very important. Everything was very important what we addressed. We talked about PCs, we talked about software, but now we have to do something for the heart. And the product which is probably closest to our two hearts is the Explanar system. Last year we introduced our new Explanata, 320 by 320 millimeters, higher precision, so a few micrometers repeatability, very, very dynamic. You can do save a lot of costs because the form factor is a little bit different. And now we have just introduced a new functionality which we are showing on this exhibition for the first time. What can you tell us about this?
Yeah, so as Beckhoff, we like to experience with technology and try new technology out. And we also like to play with magnetic fields.
Yeah, that's
We're doing that with the Explanar. And with this new tile, so you can see right now, we have a complete new way of moving the movers because we can rotate the movers now endlessly in each and every single position of the tile, which was not possible before. We could only do it at certain places while standing still. Now we can do it while moving in X and Y direction. We can rotate by 360 degrees. New kind of movement, new possibilities for transporting products. This is just one of the really cool features that Explanar enables and which PC-based control and artificial intelligence enables because this is what brings this rotation to the Explanar.
Yeah, and it's, again, just a software update, yeah? Thank you very much, Johannes. Have a nice day in Hannover and we will see each other later.
Thanks, Felix. Have fun.
Thank you.